And then you've got these Roman guards that come in, and they can do whatever they want to. And he could knock on any door that he wanted to and says, I want you to carry my luggage for a while. I want you to do that. And Jesus is taking on that one thought, knowing that it goes on in society, knowing that it happens, he's trying to bring an understanding of God into that. If a soldier demands that you carry his gear for a mile, carry it 2 miles. You see, Jesus Christ comes into the culture. God's Son comes that we would not go with the culture, that we would go countercultural. In Colossians chapter 3, verse 23, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for men. When you take the opportunity of just giving to others, not expecting a response, not expecting compensation, but just to let me serve you, it's revealing the compassion that come from your heart because Jesus Christ has shared that compassion with you. And when you share it with others, it stands out in this world. I believe that people go the second mile when they have the opportunity of controlling their attitude to always look on it positive, even when they're working in difficult situations. Why? Because that's not an attitude of this world. Jesus walked the first mile and left heaven and came to earth as a baby. But the second mile, he took it all the way to the cross and paying the penalty for your and my sin. And when we go the second mile with the way that we live our life, with the way that we carry out our work, it stands out and it brings glory and honor not to us, but to God. Will you go the second mile? Will you live your life differently to bring glory and honor to God?